Sports pregame show.
Yeah, yeah, what it do, what it do, man. Yo, Dre and this motherfucker playing this clean ass 2K16 for the full year, dude. Just chilling this shit right now, you know what I'm saying? Just started this shit, so let's get to it, man. Alright, go on.
The Houston Rockets. And for Houston, they've been on a tremendous run, and we're deep enough into the season now to know that it's no mirage. These guys definitely for real.
Yeah, I'm saying.
Well, if you want to describe the two teams going at it tonight, they are fresh, young, and hungry. Kenny, how hard is it for these two coaches to get their guys to play consistently?
I mean, experience is probably the most valuable tool in the NBA, and that inexperience makes it hard. You know, it's a teaching tool. You got to yell a lot. Start pulling your hair out. That's why I'm bald, because I was pulling my hair out, you know, to some of my younger players that I play with. But it's important to reinforce that. Tough luck.
Yeah, you know, you can't let the young guys get too high or too low. You know, both teams are making excellent progress. Should be a good fight tonight, Ernie.
Fresh, young, and hungry. That would be fresh, young, and hungry.
That's right.
Great movie. Great
I need
movie.
A sandwich right now.
Yeah.
Which one of those is Kevin Harlan? I don't know, but let's check in with him.
He's probably hungry.
I'm Dre and it's motherfucker, man. Bang, bang.
Now that's the way it's done. Take it up and throw it down with everything.
That's right. The clock, he was not going to take the soft approach on that drive.
I would certainly hope not. I mean, you get that kind of opportunity with a little resistance from the defense, you got to take that.
And so the Houston Rockets get the first points of the ball game. Here's Wiggins, off target from the baseline.
Oh, there.
Yeah, found his stride early and just kept strutting his stuff right to the tune of Rookie of the Year.
Here's money. James Harden picking up that last basket. Shot's good.
They're going to have to come up with a variation. This guy just too much speed.
Timberwolves on defense, and this is the first season matchup for them against this Rockets team. And slam dunk by Jordan.
Superb assist there. Played the role of the maestro on that.
Here in the first, a little over a minute played so far. The pass to Wiggins. Uncovered, and that one's good. Wiggins has got his first basket.
Really nice way to get your first bucket of the day.
To the left side wing. Here's the prodigy. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
And, you know, the defense gets their money's worth from that foul. Stopping the layup and not giving up the and one.
The Rockets shooting their first free throws of the game on this trip to the line.
And they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
Yeah, in general, they've been very solid. I mean, free throw shooting isn't something they've had to worry about too much this season, guys.
so he hits both.
Boy, I tell you what, he does not look like your typical big man up there at the line. He has an excellent stroke and a percentage to match.
Here's money. It's a pick by Love. And Harden comes to help. Love hits to Wiggins. From 12 feet out, and again it's Minnesota.
I tell you what, guys, it's going to be a tough day on this defense, but he's got the A-game rolling tonight.
Here's Malone, and he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
That was a slick passing from Harden on that.
In about 2 minutes play here in the first quarter, the Timberwolves have gone 3 of 4 from the field to start off the game. There's the screen. Love with the screen on Harden. Here's Money, guarded by Harden. Wiggins kicks to Love. Just 5 on the clock. There's the triple. Off the line, Minnesota.
There. Kidding me?
Defensively, that possession better not start a trend because they just handed him 2 points.
To the middle, here's Malone, and it takes that one up and powers it through.
Rock hard finish there, guys.
And only one hand needed for that one.
Yeah, and sometimes that's all you need.
Here's Money. 1:16 left to play in the first quarter. He feeds it to Love.
Nope.
Oh, and a fast break for the Rockets.
Ooh-wee. You already know, man. Doing it big, man.
So the Timberwolves called their first timeout.
Yeah, saw some things that just weren't working for them and wants to make some adjustments.
Yeah, and no reason to wait around to do that, Greg. I mean, might as well make those adjustments right away.
Big group substitution now for Minnesota. There's a minute left to play in the first quarter. Pass to Pierce. They set the pick. Pass to Springer. Let's the three fly, and he gets the bucket.
There's a chance he can have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
Rockets leading by 3. There's the prodigy, and there's the foul. It's on the bulldozer. That's his first foul. Sinks it. What range from outside. Wow. And first about 3.5 minutes in.
Kidding me, man? She didn't even fucking...
To the right side.
The trail. Come on, the trail.
From past the arc.
Rick. Ooh-wee.
Going with the triple, his first basket of the game.
How about that for a response?
Well, it sounded as though, or at least it looked as though it sounded like...
What? Fucking kidding me?
And the pass to Cassell.
Damn.
Now, Town. They get it again. And it is good! The buzzer!
He beats the buzzer to end the quarter.
Terrific shot there, I mean. He was calm, poised, didn't rush it at all. You gotta tip your hat to him. That was well done.
So far, it's been a closely contested game as we get the second quarter up and going. And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Rockets.
They've been making some really nice passes out there, excellent passing. That could set the tone for the rest of the game.
And also, it's been a positive to watch that they attacked the paint offensively as well. It's really been about the balance that they've shown.
We got Cassell. Pierce is out there with Kevin Love. And it's Fox. And it's Sprewell in at the 2. That's the 5 to begin the second quarter for the Timberwolves. Timberwolves trail by 3. To the inside. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Here's has got his first bucket in this one.
Just such a well-rounded offensive player. He's got a little bit of everything.
Well, Paul Pierce hinted that he could hang him up soon. He had that amazing run.
Can't stop my nigga, man.
He's going to go down as one of the all-time greats, no doubt about it. So many big moments over the course of his career. And also, for all the kids out there, the best maybe football.
Ah, you kidding me?
If you want to improve with a player, that's Paul Pierce's football.
Minnesota making a switch here. Jackson. Marbury. Just over 1 minute has passed here in the second quarter.
Well, the competitive nature was on display early in the career of Pierce. I mean, he has willed his teams to win his entire career and is baffled by anybody who doesn't want to win as bad as he does.
Here's the prodigy. He picked up 21 points in their last win against the Sonics in Boston.
And what I enjoyed when watching that game was the way he balanced getting his shot and also incorporating his teammates.
So it's Minnesota now, following the score by Houston. Here's Love. The Timberwolves again can't hit.
And that competitive nature that you talked about. What sets him apart, he had so many great clutch moments in the postseason. Easily one of the most clutch players in recent memory.
From Detroit, and another three for Houston.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
And it's not just their passing, but also the body movement off the ball that's created a lot.
Jordan.
Yeah, that would be an instant momentum shift. That certainly was a rim rip.
Timberwolves trail by eight.
This ain't rapping, this is street hop. Now get up off your like your seat's hot. My lob lit up. Trunk of the car, we got the street.
And the Timberwolves call time. In addition to going over the game plan and making whatever necessary adjustments have to be made, Greg, this timeout also the time for players to get rehydrated or hydrate for the first time with some Gatorade. Plenty of basketball still to be played here, and they have to get recharged.
That's a great point. Without proper hydration, a player can completely run out of gas down the stretch of a game. And that's something that none of these guys can afford to have. If you're going to battle all the way to the finish, you've got to be
Stephon Marbury! Six points with the basket for money. For Houston, they've gone 5-6 so far.
Second got a point.
Fadeaway, and O'Neal gets it to go.
Well, he knew how many inches he had over the guy. I mean, let's face it, quick decision to just rise up and take the jump shot.
On the wing, Jackson. Here's Towns. And Shaq with the rebound.
Right thing there to stay that tight on him and really try to keep him out of this competition.
Yeah, me.
They're taking advantage, Clark, of a team that looks lost out there.
Guys, this
one. See, you got them 11s on, man. Shit. I say that shit every game. Because the motherfuckers are so clean, bro. Nope. Oh, you kidding me, nigga? That nigga Stephon. He's doing that shit right now, man.
Have we seen the possession take that from them today? Ending with a basket coming off a quick pass.
Well, when you look at the assist total, yeah, they've been clearly the better team.
And they're pushing it up.
As far as me, I'm still caught up Well, there you go. One team operating on all cylinders at either end, steals fast break buckets, and the other team scrambling to find its game.
Great point. I mean, that aggression has allowed them to just create a lot of.